everybody, I'm Claire, and welcome to my video blog. Well, I've been watching the froth and bubble over the weekend, the last couple of days. There's been so much going on, and positions seem to have changed kind of almost by the hour. And one of the things that I found most interesting was this fake petition that appeared over the weekend. Apparently it was some kind of petition that was set up before the referendum. I don't quite understand that. But anyway, it was signed up with several million people with IP addresses in foreign parts, as far apart as Uzbekistan and those places as far as widely apart as that. And was it 30,000 from the Vatican City, which has a population of 800, and so on and so forth. And it's absolutely incredible that the BBC apparently was running with this, even when it had been exposed. However, I'm very glad to say that there does seem to have been a repudiation of it, whether it was acknowledged to be a fake or not. I saw a... Well, it wasn't mentioned. There was no mention of a second referendum in Cameron's speech in Parliament this afternoon. He may be dragging his feet a little bit. Obviously, I don't really know about the technicalities of this thing. But there was no mention of a second referendum. He reaffirmed the fact that this would be respected and implemented, and that it would go ahead, that the Cabinet all agreed that this morning. And doubtless there will be many snares along the way, and people, you know, like the multinational globalists, well, maybe they've kind of resigned themselves to the fact that we're leaving now. So they're just going to cause as much trouble as they possibly can. But I'm sure we will just have a continuing, endless, lingering whine from people who will be trying to stop it in this country. And I'm inclined to think this reminds me of... this reminds me of something out of The Lord of the Rings, which is like a sequel to what I did the other day about the end of the realm of Sauron. But I suppose I should say first that I think that it's very easy to get... I must admit, I mean, for instance, I had a bit of a wobble last night, Sunday, after watching a few videos, and quite legitimate warnings from people like Paul Joseph Watson and David Icke, all warning about the fact that they there are people who don't really want this to happen, and they would people who would be like who would like to stop it, and they will cause us resistance, and they will try and stop us. But at the same time, it's really, you know, this is so much bigger. This is so much bigger. What's going on is so much bigger than that, because I can't keep up with the news at the moment. But I saw just reading a news item that actually came out on Friday, already on Friday, right? This is Monday, the 27th of June. And even on Friday, apparently, virtually within hours of the result happening, we were hearing that the Netherlands, France, Italy and Denmark, and possibly others, including Sweden, were all in various different stages of wanting, expressing that they were going to have a referendum. I think Netherlands is the first, the most advanced on that. So we'll probably see some development on that if Marine Le Pen gets elected as president next year, which is looking more likely now, then she will do the same. She will, and Italy could have a referendum, but they would have to, but referenda aren't legally binding in Italy in the way they are here, or, well, not exactly here, but anyway. And apparently the people at the centre in Brussels are wanting to impose and push ahead, which is the thing that we always knew. All these people who said, oh, you know, vetoes, you can retain, blah, 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 blah. This seems to be really absolute nonsense. And because they're already pushing for further integration not only of currency and borders, but even of taxation. And so this is exactly what people have been saying for many years. And so I think that another thing is that even if these people who are pushing for a second referendum actually got it, I think they would regret it, because things are moving so fast with the EU now. They're talking, there's top people now talking about the need for an EU army, the need for individual national armies being phased out. Now that's not going to go down well with countries like France, for instance. And we've gone into a real kind of froth situation. And of course, in this country, David Cameron, at least for himself, managed to, he's hanging on to the tiller, hanging on to the wheel, and tried to do this in an orderly fashion, at least. Making a joke today against Jeremy Corbyn, who seems to be having a very, very turbulent time. I just really don't know what to make of Corbyn. I think he was a reluctant Remainer, wasn't he, or something? But obviously the Labour Party is tearing itself apart pretty quickly. So I think anything that immediately kind of emerges in terms, well, you see, we've got this kind of stuff from people like David Lammy. Oh yes, oh, I saw some absolutely atrocious tweets by the disgusting Peter Sutherland, who is a UN person, and I'd only ever seen publicity photographs of him before, but I actually saw a short video of him, and he looked grotesque. He looked like some kind of cave troll out of Lord of the Rings, really. I mean, God. And he was tweeting these disgusting tweets saying there must be some way to get this referendum reversed, and those stupid people in Britain, what have they done? I just thought, this guy is just absolutely ludicrous. I mean, I sent back a few of my own, but I couldn't stay. Honestly, it was like it was emanating some kind of poisonous vibration. Anyway, so those are the people, actually, you see, they're really, I think that it's, they know that they've lost. I know, even though, you know, like these people in the shop I had the other day, you know, they're trying to get this, these people want a second referendum, they're really angry with the Leavers, and they're just trying to get their own way, but it's more kind of vicious, because they know that it's not going to happen for them. They can see it slipping away. Oh, God. So, what I wanted to read here was another little quote. This won't be quite so continuous. And I'm going to have to be quite selective about this, because it's it's a little bit more obscure than the previous one. Well, I do believe that the power has gone out. It's echoing around Europe. this hammer blow on Thor's Day against the Thor's construction. But they're still kind of echoing, there's still the kind of the ghost of the shadow echoing around. So I want to just try and read a few lines. And it's kind of like the voice of Saruman, when Saruman comes to the balcony to talk with Gandalf and Theoden and the company. He tries to beguile them with his soft words, but because he's lost it all, you know, and then Gandalf even breaks his staff, you know, and yet he still carries on trying to, you know, if he can't overpower people with his subtlety and his voice, he just is really spiteful and horrible to them. And that's kind of what we've got here. So he says things like, "But come now," said the soft voice. "Gandalf, at least, I know too well to have much hope that he seeks help or counsel here. But you, Theoden, Lord of the Mark, are declared by your noble devices. Why have you not come before as a friend?" This is kind of probably Junker or Soros or Mark will say, "Oh, no, I want to suck up back to you now," you know. Then he says, "But I say, Theoden King, shall we not have peace and friendship, you and I? It is ours to command," you know. This is after he's tried to, you know, destroy the riders of Rohan and their people, just like the EU is trying to destroy our people. And then everybody's worried that Theoden is going to give in and, you know, go up there with him. And then he says, we will have peace when you and all your works have perished. So I do not need to lick your fingers, turn elsewhither. But I fear your voice has lost its charm. And then finally with Gandalf, he says, "But you, Gandalf, for you at least I am grieved, feeling for your shame. How comes it that you can endure such company, for you are proud? Even now will you not listen to my counsel? Oh, you know, you can come back to the EU. We want to go back to the EU. Believe in the EU. What have you to say that you did not say at our last meeting? Or perhaps you have things to unsay." Ha. And then just as the riders and everybody are afraid that Gandalf will go up and be tempted by Saruman, of course, Gandalf just turns him away and breaks his staff. And really, it's kind of like what we've got now. It's just like this echo, this spectral whining where they're trying to persuade us. And even if they could, there are so many echoes going around that the EU would be falling apart from the Netherlands leaving, or from Denmark, and we couldn't have a referendum immediately, so it would have to be, you know, way down the line after these negotiations have already been put in place. And just look at the mess, look at all the future tyranny that they're already planning, look at the financial mess that's already happening and getting worse by the day. There's the complete mess with Turkey, with the migrants, refugees, Africans coming across the... It's just like anybody who really imagines that they could swing it all around, that it was just luck, on the part of those leavers. They just managed to get ahead. They just, if we did it again, though, the Remain camp would swing it back. All those nice people like Bob Geldof with their, flicking obscene gestures at hardworking people. I mean, I think that we can have, we can have this wobble that I had yesterday, and we can think, they might snatch it away from us. They will bloody try. Yeah, there's absolutely no doubt about it. They are trying all the time, but the momentum of this is already well underway, and these people are clutching at straws, and that is why they have to be so spiteful and so mean and deceptive, setting up false internet petitions, really. I mean, this is the level that they're at. So, yes, they will keep doing this kind of thing, but it's a bit like pea shooters against a Centurion tank, I'm inclined to think. We just have to keep firm and just laugh at these people, because, I'm not a great believer in the political parties that we have in Westminster, but I do recognise that when they carry things out, that they do have the full momentum and power of the state behind them, and they do seem to me beginning to implement this, and the forms do seem to be being carried out, and it maybe is taking a little bit longer than we would like, but it does seem to be going ahead, and these people are trying to stop it. They want to make it difficult, but I think really that's all they can do. They can just make it difficult and uncomfortable for us, and they really, and even if they did manage to slow us up completely and jam us up, it would all carry on in Europe, and Europe is falling apart anyway. It's just like either we just get out and it all happens, or we remain with it and it's just nastier and messier. So this is all just the delusional voice of Saruman. It's just lies, deceit, and I think we'll be all right. So stand firm, and I must just show you this before I go. I got this. We've got that. There we go. I got that from the shop where the owner was a little bit unkind to me the other day. I got it a few days before. There was none left on the shelf when I got back, so I don't know whether they sold them all or they put them away. Anyway, so thank you very much for watching. Stay strong, and don't let them steal you, because it's all just a mind game of confidence and self-belief. We've got it. We've got the Earth plane thing happened, and we just have to follow it through. So, stay strong. Thanks for watching. Bye.